Hey everyone, I'm Dan from jazzcomposerspresent.com, an online space where composers, musicians, and listeners come together to celebrate the music we love. I'm joined today by Miho Hazama, Grammy-nominated composer, arranger, chief conductor of the Danish Radio Big Band, permanent guest conductor of the Metropole Orchestra, and leader of her own internationally acclaimed chamber ensemble, M-Unit. Miho is here to show us how she found creative inspiration by composing backwards.
Hi everyone. How did you start composing? Maybe you come up with the first theme and then the bridge into the second idea. But sometimes you can compose backwards. And here's an example for you today. This is a piece called From Life Comes Beauty from my Jazz Chamber Orchestra M-Unit's latest album, Beyond Orbits. This composition was originally commissioned by a cosmetic company for a short movie. And so I composed a 2.5 minute piece for it. You just listen to the verse, bridge, and a chorus of the composition. So I really liked this composition, so I decided to expand it for my orchestra's new record. But how? I decided to set this 2.5 minute part at the end of the composition, and then to make a new creation for the first part, inspired by this. So first of all, I quote a bridge section from the original piece to make an intro and a new theme for the first part. Let's take a look at the slide one while I play the bridge section from the original piece. Here it is. Did you see all the quotes in the intro and the new theme? Let's take a listen to the intro of the and also the theme of the new part, which is the beginning of the new composition. I basically quoted the exact same melody line and then put the new chord progression on this section. To continue with that section, I wanted to get one more motif from the original piece. So let's take a look at the slide two. The top line in the two staves in the is a verse from the original piece. And then the bottom line is a retrograde of the melody. So I decided to use this retrograde tone row as a bridge of the new part. Then later, which is in the next section on slide three, I put the line from the original piece's chorus on top of the chord progression, which you can see on a French horn on the score. So in this section, in the letter F, you can see both of the retrograde tone row as the melody, and then the line from the chorus part together on a French horn. And then as you can hear, this section led to the solo section. Then I wanted to connect this one to the original piece. To do so, I started having the verse line from the original piece as a back line of the solo. And then I made it on an interlude, kind of that bridge, new bridge part, repeating a melody from the bridge of the original piece, which is now the same as the intro of the piece. In this way, you can kind of get the sense or hints before those motifs come back. Let's listen to this part. We're going to play from letter M on the score, and then where you see French horn and tenor saxophone playing the background line. And then letter N and then O are a new bridge to that original piece. Yeah, the last piano part was actually the original piece's intro. So the connection was complete. So this is how I came up with the new constructions of the composition called Life Comes Beauty. It's fun to think different way to get inspired. And then there's no rule to start a composition from the beginning. So I hope this was somehow interesting. And then it was giving you a new inspiration for a composition. Happy writing, and see you next time.
Thanks for watching today's mini lesson. Be sure to like, share, and subscribe. Drop any questions, comments, or suggestions for future videos down below. To watch our full-length events and participate in live Q&As with our presenting artists, head to jazzcomposerspresent.com. Thanks, and we'll see you next time.